Hi everyone, this is Kristen. I'm the Science and Engineering Librarian at Miami University. This is one in a series of videos we have on patents, and today we'll be reading or deciphering a U.S. patent. All right, before we go too far, I need to be clear and say that this video is just a very general overview. Patents are legal documents, and if you're doing research to actually submit a patent application, you'll need to be very thorough and seek help from a patent and trademark resource center and/or legal assistance. The library staff at these centers are trained experts on searching but are not attorneys and cannot provide legal advice. Miami University libraries are not a patent or trademark resource center, currently don't have specialists of this kind, nor are we attorneys. All right, let's check out the major parts. The front page, the drawings, the specifications, and the claims. Normally, patents have all of these parts, but not always. Let's get into the details now and pick things apart a bit more. All right, the front page. Similar to a journal article, the front page of a patent has a lot of useful information on it. It's a little easier to read than the rest of the text of the patent. However, there are numbers in parentheses by each bit of information, which are not presented in numerical order, and this can be a little confusing. All right, let's get back to our example. For starters, we have the document type, which is U.S. patent. We also have the patent number and the patent application number. Next, we have the invention title and the date of the patent. Here's the applicant and inventor. Sometimes this is the same person and other times not. We also have the name of the attorney firm or agent that helped file or prepare the patent. Now we have the term extension notice, so how long the patent is good for, if there's an extension to the usual term. There's also the date the application was filed. Then we have the international patent classification, followed by the U.S. patent classification, including the CPC, the cooperative patent classifications. The field of search, this is the searches done by the examiner when reviewing the patent. And moving along to the references cited, this consists of prior art listed on the patent application or those found by the examiner during review. And we also have the abstract. So that's the front page and its parts. As I mentioned, it's generally the same patent to patent, but you will see some variations and some parts that we didn't discuss here. All right, the drawings are next. Here's a few types you might see. This is not an exhaustive list. Perspective or 3D, section or cutaway, exploded or expanded view, block diagram or flowchart. On an occasion, a drawing of prior art is included, and these aren't part of the patented invention and will be labeled as prior art. We don't have any of these in our example. Let's go back and see what we do have, though. This example has quite a few drawings, and there are no captions near them. The captions or descriptions are on the later pages. The parts here are numbered, and these numbers are referenced in the description in bold. So here we have figure 1 and 2. The numbered parts correlate between the figures. That's the basics when it comes to the drawings, so let's move on to the specifications. This consists of all the textual parts of the patent, excluding the first page information and the claims. Typical parts of the specifications include the title, background, summary, brief description of the drawings, and a detailed description. Let's look at our example again and pick these parts out on the page. These parts are well labeled, and there's nice spacing between them, so it's visually broken up as well. We can see that there's two columns of text numbered in bold up at the top, and there are small numbers down the middle of each line of text, both to make it easier to refer to specific parts of the patent. All right, so we have the title of the patent at the top left, and the background of the invention, then the summary. Next is a brief description of the drawings. Recall on the drawing pages that there were no captions or descriptions. This is where you'll find those. And then we have a detailed description of the drawings. In this section, the part numbers we saw earlier are referenced in bold. This is fairly straightforward. The claims, as we'll see next, are much less so. Okay, so let's talk quickly about the claims. Visually, the claims are a numbered list of individual, often rather lengthy, sentences. Their purpose is to set the limits on what the patent does and doesn't cover, and for this reason, they're often written legalistically and therefore aren't easy to understand or read. It's sometimes best to seek professional help from someone like a patent attorney, especially if you're applying for a patent. I'm a librarian and not a lawyer, so I can't help interpret these, but let's look at our example and see where we can find them. Okay, so we have a big block of text here, and the claims section starts somewhere in here, but the nice spacings and the headings are gone. It starts here, and it says, the invention claimed is, and then it goes on for a while, and in the next column, we can see the bold numbers for each claim. And if we read it, we can also see that oftentimes each claim refers back to the previous claims. On the next page of the patent, the claims continue in column 5 and in column 6. And that, folks, is the end of this patent. We've reached page 8. All right, let's wrap up this video with a quick review of the patent parts we looked at. The front page, lots of information in separate parts, the drawings with the numbered parts that are detailed later on in some of the specifications, and then the claims, which explain what the patent does and doesn't cover. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it was helpful to you. There are other videos in this series about patents, so please check those out as well.